You don't know.
What I just did is because it's important to keep an eye on each other. I have been preaching since 2 weeks ago when I came, and you've been hearing my preaching. But this morning, my strong desire is to have a heart-to-heart talk with you. It's preaching, yes, but it goes beyond preaching. It's to have a heart-to-heart talk. That's why I was looking forward to every person's face that I'm not seeing here. And you will have to help me repeat whatever I say with them. I want to talk to you, and I want you to talk to me. Because there is a great plan that God has for every single one of you. Not only that, your place and your role in the years ahead is strong. If we are going to have a future, it's if you have a future. As a church, we'll have a future. If your family that you came from will have a future, it's because you have a future. Right? Now, so your life is a stake, not only in the kingdom of God on the generic note, but in the family you came from. Your life, you have a stake in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. You have a stake. And so let's get that clear. And I'm very, very clear in my mind that what you become in future is critical to the future of this church. Right? What you become in future is critical to the future of this church. And I'm not joking about it, because the last time I was talking with Joe, and Joe, you said you were going to, Joe, your plan is it electrical engineering or medicine? Mechanical engineering. Did you change? Always mechanical. Okay. All right. Now, when I remember such things, I see the future. I see the future. We can preach. We can pray. There's plenty of seats in front here. Come closer, Esther. Let me. I'm going to be sure you're hearing my voice. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So it's critical for us to settle that at the back of our mind. We have a great future. We have a stake in the kingdom of God. We have a stake in this church. We have a stake in your family. And that's why your spiritual life, you can't be flippant with it. That's why your career plan, you cannot be flippant with it. Are you with me? That's why even the vision that you have must begin now. You see, the journey of 1,000 years begins with one step. Just one step. So if you are dreaming of what you're going to be in 1,000 years, what you do today affects what happens in 1,000 years. Actually, 1,000 years is only a multiple of 1 hour. An accumulation of an hour is of an hour and an hour and an hour and an hour is what makes 1,000 years. Hallelujah. Okay, in this gathering, as we are seated here now, among all of you, the person that knows me for the longest is Mama Cash. Now, in size, we probably have not changed in size. But you see how long we've been coming from. You see what we are today. Think back that today is affected by since all this while. Am I making some sense? So what I'm asking about, you know, your colleagues is because you must be like an anchor. Put your hand in my hand. Like that. It must be a chain, and then she puts her horn and put her horn. If anybody is getting to be a weak link, you jack the person up and becomes a strong link. And you don't find the person in church, say, what's happening to you? That's why the WhatsApp group for the youth is there for. Amen? What's happening to you? And then the Bible says, iron sharpened iron. That's how a man sharpens the countenance of his friend. So when I'm thinking positive, I'm thinking plans, I'm having progress, and I post on the youth WhatsApp page, you sharpen me one way or the other. When I was growing up as a Christian, I used to play around some boys because of the way they pray on campus. I like to hang around them because when they pray, I'm going to be challenged to pray. In fact, when I was talking about Ogun State University yesterday, was my first experience in the university. Now, I moved from my hostel to another hostel because the guys that stay in that hostel, they pray and they study the Bible. So I know that when I go into their hostel, just spend the night with them, I know that I'm going to come back fired up, charged up with a clear vision. Now, that flat that I used to go to, we were all students. Every single one of them and me are in the ministry today. At that time, we were just students studying. Right? One is a pastor in London. He has branches in Nigeria and other places. One of them is a pastor in Israel. Myself, I'm doing what God has asked me to do. You got the point? Now, and they're all successful. Two of them are doctors. The other one is a business tycoon. Along with the father, they are called of God. Amen? So when we create a link that is strong, let's do it again. When we create a link that is strong, you make sure nobody's lost. We must be on the journey together. And that's the only way I will challenge you, because we are not so far from each other. I can challenge you. You can challenge me right here. Now, let me give you a tip of the iceberg of 5 years from today. What's your vision in 5 years? What do you want to be? What has Father revealed to you that you're supposed to be? Don't know yet. Okay, what do you do right now? What class are you? You're doing A-level. So when you finish A-level, what do you want to go and study? Don't know yet. Good. I'm glad for that sincere discussion. So see, put the link again. As we are in that link, and you just chat about your career future, something triggers in your spirit man about, okay, now that's a good idea. You get the point? Somebody who is rubbing on you says, oh, this is my dream. Oh, that's my vision. You two say, okay, yeah, that's a good idea. You get the point? While you are praying, it's important to know that the journey we are going, only one step at a time is what we need, but we're going somewhere. So what's your vision? Miss George, I've become a lecturer. I have your own school. It's clear, right? So right now you are studying what? Look at this. This is a typical, very good example. And I've seen that in many of you. You want to be a lecturer. You want to have your own school. And you are studying educational management. What can be more precise than that? Clear vision, clear goal, you're on course. Are you getting my point? Now, at this level of our age group, you see, have you drawn a V before? Have you drawn, many of you, if you went to a school where there's bush in the school that you go to. When I was in high school, we have a farm area. If you are late, in fact, in our football field, if you are late, the senior people will just come and draw a V on the ground. Go and cut that grass. Just a small V like this, cut it. And you know the V, the length of the V keeps widening up like this. You know, by the time you move more, it has widened and widened and widened. That's what a V is about. So what am I trying to say? Now, right now, you all look small. Right now, the difference is so small between the two of you. Right now, I'm a grandfather. Many of my colleagues, when we were growing up, and we're starting to say, so what's God, who is going to be your life partner? Ah, forget about. Now they're asking me, how did you do it? And we're age mates, even their kids are still small. You know, those kind of stuff. You know, you must be clear where you are going. Because in 5 years, V that is so small like this becomes like that. Put your hand again in my hand. We must maintain the link so that when the V becomes big, the disparity will not be too wide. We must keep each other up. We must jack each other up spiritually, career, emotionally, financially. Iron sharpen iron. That's how a man sharpens the countenance of his friend. If you are really friend, we're supposed to challenge each other to growth and unto godliness, to prosperity, to wealth. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. What's your vision? I asked you before, you remember, under that canopy over there. Law and medicine. They are far apart, but that's a good thing to begin with.
Law and medicine are really far apart. If you want to be a medical doctor, you are going to be pure science. If you want to be in the law, you're going to be very literal. So at this age, at this your class, it's good to still be so diversity, but as you grow older, you're going to be zeroing down. But the point is that you are saying law or medicine makes you know you must study. You get the point? That's good enough for you to keep going and keep praying. Lord, what do I want to be? Lord, what should you want me to be? This I'm sharing with you is so critical. It's so critical. So in 5 years, what grade are you now? What grade are you? What class are you? SS1. So SS1 means you have 2 more years and you finish secondary school. SS1 means you have 2 more years and finish secondary school. Right? So in 5 years' time, you will either be in law, in studying law already, or studying medicine. In 5 years' time. In 5 years, it is law, you'll be about to finish. Are you with me? Alright, so 5 years is such a clear, very close, but the difference will become huge. Now, that keeps you focused, keeps you going. We are talking about the what's the theme of your youth program again last month? Youth with a difference. Youth with a difference doesn't just happen. One of the key things in their life is clear vision. You see, last night, I was listening to two YouTube videos. I played one of them like 7 times. Maybe if any other person had me in the house, I played it again. One man of God was telling his life history of how he became born again at 15. I think I've shared it before on our WhatsApp page. At 15, and then by the time he was 53, what he had become. He became a chancellor, big church, big ministry, popular person you know. But how he got a clear vision, how he got born again, how he began to do ministry, how he began to focus, and in 26 years of life and ministry was something else. I got challenged. Lord of heaven, have mercy on me. I'm not young anymore. Do you get the point? I don't want you at your age to grow up to my age before you begin to think, what am I going to become? Youth with a difference begins with clear vision. At 15, the guy knew he had to be born. He knew that he wants to serve God. By the time he was 19, he preached his first sermon. By the time he was 27, he got into ministry. By the time he was 53, man, the world knows him. He has the largest single cathedral in the world today, as far as gathering people. Well, of course, that's an aspect. Only God knows our achievement. But the point, it was clear. It was focused. He pursued his dream. I don't want you to get to 5 years' time and you still be asking myself, okay, what do I want to become now? Then there will be no you to be the difference. There will be a clear difference very, very soon. In this same church, if you keep focused, if you keep targeting what you are going to become, I see future in you. All right? Now, the last time I came, I asked you what your dream is, and you clarified it to me. And I'm glad you did. Right? In 5 years' time, can you imagine what you will have become? Tell me. You say it. Declare it. So shall it be. Eh? Say it. Just say it. Keep saying it. Yeah. You know what I'm asking to say? It forms out of you. It pulls something in your spirit. It pulls dedication. It pulls commitment. It clarifies focus. You don't have time to faff around. 5 years is precious. My 5 years now is delicate. I can't mess around like I can't waste time like if I ever did. I can't anymore because it's getting clear that, man, 5 years' time, I'm going to be, you know, getting close to the other realm. You know, praise God. But you have an advantage over us. That's why I'm passionate about you. You have a clear advantage over us. You can be challenged. You can keep your focus. And in 5 years' time, you will have become what heaven has ordained you to be. In 5 years' time, what do you see yourself in it? Look, some of us are new in it now, in the last... Mommy Cash, you know, Pastor, you just say, oh, in the yo. Wake up your eyes. 2 years' time, that's an architect. Are you with me? In fact, right now, in the next few months, that's the first phase of architecture is finished. You see, be saying in the but before you wake up your house, you say MD of something, you know. Do you get the point? It's a V. It's a V. That's how it goes. That's how it goes. What do you want to become when you grow up? Don't know yet. Every day you pray, ask God, Lord, show me. Lord, show me. Lord, show me. Lord, show me. Let me tell you my story. My father wanted to be a civil engineer, and he was studying civil engineering. Well, before that, he worked as a clerk and all those kind of things as he was growing up. And then he went to Canada. He was a clerk. I think it was a court clerk or something like that before he left the country. He was working with the government. And then went to Canada for further studies, studying civil engineering and doing night guard at the same time. You know, just finding work to do kind of thing. And I know one of the work he did was as a night guard, but he was a student. I was already born before he went to do all that. And all I knew was that one day he wrote me, I was in primary 4. He said, when you finish primary 6, come and join me in Canada. In primary 6, I got the news that he died. And therefore dies the dream of Canada. And I kept on living my life. When I got into Canada, I realized one day in 2006, I was invited to preach. I was living in South Africa. I was invited to preach in Canada by a church. And I went to honor the invitation. And I took a 2 weeks leave. I finished preaching. And I was just preparing to leave tomorrow. Then I sat down. And I remember, come to think of it, my father was in this country. And I began to search. Well, where was he? I was in the same city where he died. And then the question of going to Canada began to come up in my head on that visit, 2006. Then I went back to South Africa. I went to pray, Lord, what are you saying? Lord, I didn't even want to go again to Canada after a while because I wanted to stay in this church. But you see, we still went. And then in 2000, and I think in one particular year anyway, I was able to trace exactly where he was buried. Found his burial ground, took my children there, took picture of it, sent to my siblings. The dream came true. God brought it to pass. Am I communicating to you? When I ask you what you want to become, there's something heaven has earmarked for you. So when I ask Oluwaseola means to begin to pray now, it's not because now is the future, but because, you see, as I told you, a journey of 1,000 years begins with one step. 1,000 years is a conglomerate of 1 hour each. Your life today matters a great deal. Amen? What's your dream? I've asked you before, but I'll ask you again. Journalist? Yes, say it again. A writer? You write articles, and then what else? There was more that you said to me. Eh? And what else? Music. Okay. What does that take you? You want to be in music ministry? You want to be able to be an artist? Like a journalist? That's a word I'm looking for. I can't get it. But anyway, that's clear. Does it affect your life right now? Does it affect how you live your life? You finish your ND now, right? It's your second year of the ND. You go to your second year now. Then after that, you go and do 6 months attachment. That affects where you will do your attachment and things like that. It affects how much you invest in your music training right now. Your life is not a chance. I don't see you for tomorrow and next tomorrow. I see you in 5 years. As a church, I see a great army. Amen? So the youth with a difference, I knew that if I start teaching, it will take me out of a discourse with you. My intention is to have a discourse with you. I want you to remember that every day counts. Every day counts, all right? What's your plan? What do you see in 5 years? What are you doing right now? Okay. You're teaching now. What did you qualify with before? What level? ND. OND, HND? OND. Okay. And you are teaching computer now. Just teach. So what's your plan? How do we go further from here? When? You've applied. Very good. Pastor knows. Okay. You see? Keep an eye on where you are going. You can keep working. You can be doing ND. You can actually, even if you have to keep working and sponsoring yourself, but keep them going with a clear focus of where you are going. 5 years' time, you're a computer engineer. Even if you just get admission to ND now, you spend 2 years, you finish it. 1 year, you service. If you say you want to go and do a master's, as is linked to that, you still have it. Within those 5 years, you are done. If you keep taking one leg on top of each other, one leg on top of, if you don't, then you frustrate that plan. You got the point? Amen? Now, if I keep asking each of you that way until we all say it, that is critical to me. So there are three levels. I want to challenge you this morning, youth as a church. What's your name, my sister at the back? What's your name? Can you say it again? Sheyi, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Have I seen you before? Have you seen me before? Okay. Who knows her? Why didn't you mention her when I'm asking, where is she? Do you see what I'm saying? So now look around now. Who is not here right now as we speak? Look around again. Look around again. Youth ESCO, your plan, your assignment, your commitment, where are the other youth ESCOs? What's that? Go along. Uh-huh. So every Sunday morning, you find a member of this clan. I use the word clan. A member of this clan that is not in church. Bombard the person with a text message. Iron sharpen iron. That's how a man sharpens the countenance of a soul. You are a great army. So on one hand, you are the future of this church. Should I repeat that? You are the future of this church. And that's why it's important for you to be spiritually alert, to be academically inclined, to be professionally motivated, so that in the future we are talking about spiritually, you can carry the structure, spiritual structure, vision of the ministry. Number two, your career will have grown to a point where you have the means to even live the life you're supposed to live and serve God where you're supposed to serve God. Number three, you will be able to be an influence into society. Amen? Talk about Gideon. So let me spend 5 minutes now to refer to all the youth we will have studied. When that theme came, I spent time to just do a panoramic view of all the youth with a difference in the Bible. And I realized that all of the people that you find to be used of God, it began at their youth age. Most of them began at youth. In fact, some that were used at old age, you will see the trigger when they were small. For example, Solomon and Moses. Moses was a small boy, even though he didn't understand the vision God has called him to accomplish, he wanted to do it in his own power, youthful exuberance. One blow, he was so zealous a man. One single blow finished up the Egyptian. Wah! The guy died. That's a man of conviction, a man of zest, a man of compassion for the things of God, but he didn't have enough wisdom yet. He was going to do it in his own energy. But that was when the hand of God was upon him already. Wah! The man died. The next day he was saying, you guys don't fight yourselves. You want to kill me like you killed somebody yesterday? He ran away. How many years was he running for? He ran for 40 years. I'm on course. He ran away for 40 years. But he began every... Do you imagine that, really speaking, the assignment God had for him began when he was small. So the call had been at that time. He didn't understand the call. He didn't understand the premise of doing the work. But the point was, God searched him out when he was small. Do you know when God spoke to me that I'm going to be in ministry? I was studying civil engineering. 1985, I knew clearly God has a call upon my life in the pastoral and teaching ministry. And years came down the line, I knew that later as an apostolic grace combined with it. But the point is, I knew. So when we finished my first degree as a civil engineering student, and everybody was looking for a job, I said, I will not get a job that I will work on Saturday. Yo, I was clear. I said, Saturday, no. All the big companies, HFP, many big companies then, Saturday, I didn't like it. Down the line, I went back into my field. So why I wanted to be a lecturer was because I felt lecturing would give me time to do what I want to do. Ask me when I was pastoring a church, the first church I pastored in this city, I was lecturing in UI, civil engineering, and you'll find me in church office, as if that was my office. I have timetable of lectures. When it's time for my lecture, 1 hour before, I go to my office, sit down there a little bit, give my lecture, hang around for 1 hour, I'm back in Bodija, in my church office. Am I communicating with you? Everybody thought I was in full time. I was not in full time, I was in part time. Church was not paying me nothing. But I was there. I was there from that singular church. We had many more churches we planted right there. I was spent and I was given to what God was doing. Why? Because he showed me a clear vision and I'm called to serve him. Hallelujah. I was young, much younger than now. So I had known in 1985, can calculate my age, 1985, how old was I? 1985, I was 20 years old when God made it clear to me that, look, I have called you. But before then, I preached my first sermon in the headquarter church of Foursquare in this country when I was 17. In the main service, I was 17 years old. They wanted a youth to preach for the youth week. And they said, no, this guy will preach. I was 17 years old. So Moses was small when God called him. So the hand of God can rest upon you now, male or female, even if you are still in high school, even if you are still in JS classes. There is a journey in front of you. You mustn't lose sight of it. God is passionate about what has to become about you. So I'm concerned very much about your spiritual life, how much you commit to your life to God, how much you seek after God in your personal quiet time, in your daily devotion, how much odd books do you read, what you spend your time to do when you are on the social media, how much time do you spend on Facebook, and when you are there, what do you do? How much time do you spend watching movies? What kind of movies? How much time do you spend listening to messages? Or is it just music all the time? All right? There are CDs to get from the church. Now, I've been speaking to them in the media section. For example, this weekend, they're going to put it on MP3 so everything will be on one CD. So that somebody will just put it in. You can even find a way of distributing to them on their phone. Create an iPod kind of things, podcast. Exactly. You listen to the thing. Put your ear on the in between breaks of lectures. Listen to the messages. Listen to messages. Oh, you know. Even now, I listen to messages a lot. So, how do you grow spiritually? Get time to spend in the Word, in prayer. Listen to messages. Then, number two, invest time in your studies, please, or in your training. Some of us don't necessarily have to be in the same kind of path. You might not necessarily be a student going to, no, you might have done your school and now you are training in your handwork. Invest time to be the best in that area of your work. I was talking yesterday about anointing in every area of field. As a panel beater, as a fitter, as a carpenter, as a fashion designer, as a saloon person. Whatever skill or area of training you are supposed to go into, excel there. It takes time. It takes energy. It takes focus. It takes commitment. It takes a clear vision. The Lord will help you in Jesus' name. Amen? I have 3 or 4 more minutes. So if you look at Daniel, as a young boy, he committed himself to please God and to be excellent in his academic pursuit. That was very clear. If you look into the life of Joseph, I spent time to discuss that on Skype with you guys the other day. If you look into that, in the life of Gideon, the same example was a small boy. He said, "Who am I? I'm the least in my father's house." Remember the story? If you look into the life of other people that God used and God intended to use, if you look at the life of Timothy, Timothy was a small boy, and God says that Paul, he go to a point, and Paul said, "I'm going to leave you in Crete. You are the bishop of Crete now. You are the bishop of Ephesus now." A small boy. If you look at the life of David, David was a small boy, but he finished Goliath at 15 or 16 years old. Was a man who knew God at 15 to 16 years old. All the army of Israel were shaking when Goliath would come out. But David said, "Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that would defy the army of God?" He knew covenant relationship with his God at age 15 and 16. Hallelujah. Look at Samuel. Samuel was a small boy that was serving. He was put in the house of Eli to serve Eli, to put water in the bathroom for him, to shine his shoes, to carry his bag, to make food for him as a servant. But it was there God called him. Samuel was so faithful that he knew the voice of Eli even when he was sleeping. So Samuel was sleeping and he had a voice. He thought it was Eli. Actually, God had to use Eli's voice to get his attention because Samuel didn't know God's voice as at that time. It was his faithfulness and commitment as a servant to Eli that made him be able to be called of God, to him to hear God. That's why when the third time has happened, Eli had to explain to him, "I think God is calling this boy." Next time when you hear any voice that says, "Samuel, Samuel," tell him, "Oh, speak, Lord, for your servant is hearing." And the Bible explains the further down the line that as at this moment, Samuel didn't know the voice of God yet. But service and labor, commitment to service, made him qualified for God to pick him out and to hear the voice of God. He was a small boy. He was not in the priesthood. He was not in the lineage of priesthood. He was not Eli's children. He wasn't qualified to be a priest, but he became a priest and a prophet. Amen? So that's Samuel for you. And then Jesus. That's beyond saying. You know that Jesus was a small boy at 10 years old. He was going to say, "Where do you think I'm going to be? I'm in my father's house, doing my work, my father's business as a 10-year-old boy." Praise God. Make some sense? When I see you in 5 years, what will have become of your life? What will have become of your life in 5 years? That's my guy going for biz at me, right? In 5 years, you will have finished your biz at me. In 5 years, you have not started now. But in 5 years, you are done. Clear. Keep your vision clear. Keep your focus clear. Now, Master George, you told me what you wanted to do the last time. I forgot. Tell me again. Computer engineer. All right? So keep your vision clear. Keep your focus clear. Keep your understanding clear. Keep your dream alive. All right? Please, I beg you. God needs you. What does my... Shane, right? Shane, what do you do? Sorry, speak it loud. You are a student. Studying what? Social? Business studies. Where? Can somebody help me to amplify her? Since you know her, tell me more about her. Business education, where? Exactly. Where? Where? Oyo. Okay, so in the future, you want to be an educationist, right? Keep your vision clear. You get the point? In 5 years' time, what you think is small now will become real. In 5 years' time, come and see Dami and his workshop and his business. All your cars you'll be bringing to him in 5 years' time. All of you will have cars. And then you'll be lining down, and he will put you on schedule. This is okay. I have time for you. So time. In 5 years, you'll be amazed what God will have done with your life. In the name of Jesus, I speak over you. You will prosper. You will blossom. You will grow. You will grow from grace to grace, from strength to strength. You will not miss it. You will not falter. You will not fail. You will not lose focus. You will be a youth with a difference. In the name of Jesus Christ, God will be able to depend on you. As you grow in your career development, you will not be derailed by wrong friendship. Your vision will keep you focused in serving God. God will help you in your studies. God will help you in fulfilling your dreams. God will find you useful in His house. The zeal of God's house will consume you. It shall be well with you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Can we all make our link, please? Everyone. Just make a link somehow. It doesn't have to be a circle. Just make sure you are linking with somebody. Everyone, link up. There must be no weak link. All right? There must be no what?
Weak link.
So pull to the left. Everybody pull each other. Pull. Nobody must come out. Pull. So, you know what that means? When the wind is blowing somebody, now listen. When the wind is blowing somebody and he wants to fall, what will happen? The other one will hold him up. When the storm of life is blowing the other person and he wants to fall, what happened? The other one is holding up. You know, there's no falling. Get back to the link. Yeah, now, create. See, so nobody must, no, the link must not be broken. So make sure the link is strong. Get back on the link somehow. Get back on the link. If I pull and somebody falls, it's your fault. All right? We are going to have to do this exercise when there is space in one of our retreat grounds. The link must not be broken. Say it after me. The link must not be broken. Say it again. The link must not be broken. Now, what can break the link? Temptations, wrong friendship, laziness in your studies, not reading your Bible, distractions, all those kind of family pressures. Sometimes you are discouraged and you're down. Those are things and pressure that can break the link. But when you think you are weak, keep your link together. Help us say, keep your link together. You will not fail.
Amen.
You will not fall.
Amen.
You will not falter.
Amen.
You will go strong.
Amen.
From grace to grace.
Amen.
From strength to strength.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. I love you all.
Thank you, sir. Put your hands together for Pastor. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, thank you, sir. We are very grateful. God bless you, sir. God will increase the grace, the unction, the anointing upon you in the name of Jesus. Your family will keep going stronger and stronger in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm going to do something. I'm going to, well, fortunately, I can stay on Pastor's privilege of him being here to take some 5-10 more minutes. I'm going to do something very quickly. I asked everybody, just from what Pastor shared with us, I asked everybody to write their names. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2. Write the vision. Make it plain that he may run with it, that read it. Praise the Lord. Now, what I want us to do is this. If your name is not here, you can see me after now. I'm going to ask Bokola to put this on the wall in case you don't remember. I'm going to give everybody a sheet of paper if your name is here. Don't worry, it's not the book of life. And then what I want you to write is, you write your name, your phone number, your goal in life or your ambition, where you want to be in 5 years, where you want to be, I even had it 10 years, where or what you want to be in 10 years. You know, it just occurred to me, I just look back, 5 years ago, this is 2016, isn't it? 5 years ago, 2011. It looked like yesterday. Like yesterday. So that 5 years may look so far, before you know it, oh my God, it's here. Praise the Lord. So don't be afraid, don't be restricted. Just trust God and write it, and then please submit it to me. Okay? Where I am now, not no, where I am now, where you are now, I ask for your phone number in case I may need to call you for, just relax. Relax. And then the potential challenges against achieving the goal and your prayer points. Bokola, you can put this on the wall. Okay? And then we're going to do that. I'm going to call you. Really, Ayo Deji. Where is Ayo? I'm calling it, I'll put number on this. So, as your number is number one here, I'll put it. So, if you don't submit back to me, I know who you has not submitted. Oye Niro, Awe blessing. Is it Awe or Awe? Awe. Okay. Have this, my friend. Adeda Kwa Damilola. Damilola Nema. I want to call Ruko Lankwe. Akila Ade Joseph. I want to call Ruko Lankwe. Usogu Jennifer. Karim Adekola. Rokola, please let me give you. Number 7. Karim Adekola, number 7. Number 8, Famori or Damilare. Who is that? Okay. Number 9, Adewoye Peace. Number 10, Ajibola Fogolu Ashewa. Number 11, Adedakwa Inoluwa. Number 12, Agunloye Olamide. Number 13, Akilade Esther. Number 14, George Tomiwa. 15, Ajibola Angela Jesus. 16, George Tomisin. 17, Faith Oluwashola. 18, Wisdom Oluwashola. 19, Francis Odubade. 20, Adedapo Ifetoluwanimi. 21, Odubade Shalom. Well, it's on the wall. You don't have to write it now. You can write it, but make sure you give me before you go home today. 21, Odubade Shalom. 22, Ajiboye Taiwo. 23, Ogunira Titilayomi. 24, Ogunira Temiloluwa. 25, Ajibola Demlade. 26, Odubade Keoluwapo. 27, Shogutayo Peyemi. 28, Shorekola Wole. Praise the Lord. If your name is not here, you can meet me. So you write your name, then I'll give you your own sheet of paper. Okay? Do you understand? And we are going to be revisiting this because I want to put it together in a into one. And we are going to trust God to help us to begin to monitor it, to pray about it, so that if at any point the vision is changing, we will adjust. If the challenges are becoming more, we know what to pray more. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Do you agree with me that the link must not be broken? And you must not be a weak link. And the Lord will strengthen you in Jesus' name. Can I hear your amen? I said, can I hear your amen? Shall we pray? Father, we thank you this morning. We return all the glory to you. Be exalted in Jesus' name. Lord, we commit our path unto your hand. Of a truth, Lord, you will cause us to prosper. You will guide us in all our ways. We will not fail. We will not be a disappointment to the kingdom. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. For in Jesus' name we pray. Shall we share the grace together in fellowship? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Praise the Lord. God bless you.